Hi, I'm Carl Lohren from One Move to Better Golf. I would like to discuss today a very important part of the golf swing, the pre-swing waggle. The waggle is not only a movement that the arms and the hands do, but it's a movement of the feet. Back in the 50s and the 60s, when I think we had the greatest ball strikers, Hogan, Nelson, Snead, they all waggled the club and they all moved their feet. And it gave the swing a running start. It broke tension, and it previewed the way the wrist cock should take place in the swing, and it also recruited the proper muscles that start the swing. Okay, now the waggle. Let's talk about the foot movement first. Most of the great players employed foot movement and hand waggle. Some of them only used foot waggle, like Gary Player. He'd move his feet up and down. Just a little bit off the ground, the heel and the toe coming off. And that would get his body moving and create a movement and break tension. Doug Sanders, a great ball striker, same thing. They had no hand waggle, but they had their feet moving up and down. Beeman, my student, always had his feet moving up and down, okay? And then they would stop that movement when it was ready to go and they'd go, okay? Number two, there's a hand movement, an arm and a hand movement in the waggle. Hogan made the comment that the shoulders shouldn't move in the waggle because you would destroy your alignment if you did. So the movement primarily is made with the hand, with the left hand, and it moves the left forearm. And actually both hands and both forearms move, but the left hand is the leader because the left side will start the golf swing. So if you start a waggle with the left hand, it recruits the left side in order for it to move, and it prints left side. And what the waggle has two pieces to it. Number one, there's a little bit of a lift of the club so that the ball's out of the way for the waggle. And it softens the arms a little bit. The left wrist may flex a little bit, bending this way a little bit when you waggle the club, or you just may bend your elbows a little bit. But you bring the club up a little bit, 3 or 4 inches, maybe 5, depending on the player. And then you take the left hand and you waggle the club open, turn the club open, and then bring it back to where it was. And the shoulders shouldn't move, and it would look something like this. And you can couple that with your feet moving at the same time. And what it does is, it gets the left side ready to start, it breaks tension, it's easier to continue a move than to originate one, the swing grows out of that waggle, that waggle sets the tempo and rhythm for the golf swing. And the waggle also previews the way your wrists are going to break in the backswing. They're going to break the way they did in the waggle. Okay, and when they do that, you're setting a pattern for the backswing. By waggling the club, you've set a pattern for the backswing by doing that. And so what you do when you're waggling with the left hand, there's an old expression, Scottish expression, as ye waggle, ye swing. You don't want to take the club away with the right hand and lift it up, so you certainly don't want to waggle with the right hand. Because now if you do that, you're printing a right side takeaway. And you lose your extension and your width when you do that. So I believe in starting this one with the left shoulder, and I believe in waggling with the left hand, and the arm will move a little bit, this part of the arm especially, not the shoulders. Waggle it, bring it down, and you start to swing with the left shoulder. I hope that helps you, and better golf to you.